Well, hello there. I'm Shug, and I know that because my hat told me so. So the question I pose is, does your hammock fit you? Does it work for you? Because as you can see, I'm laying here in my hammock, and unlike a tent, we kind of wear our hammock. You know, we get in it and are snugged up in it, and we're nestling ourselves to be comfortable in a hammock. So I've always thought of it's almost like something that I wear. I enter it, and it becomes a part of me. And I'm laying, or is it lying? I wouldn't lie to you, out here in my Superior Gear 10-foot hammock, 55 inches wide. I feel that this hammock fits me great. It has a built-in underquilt, which, you know, anytime you add layers or sew things on a hammock, it changes everything about it. Just think of the clothes you wear, from some really thin fabric material to thick denim, and maybe you have a pair of pants or a blouse or a shirt or something that you just love, and it fits you great everywhere but in one little part. Neck's too tight, sleeves are too tight. So think about that. Does your hammock fit you? Does it suit you? Could you be doing better? Or do you have the best hammock so far? You love it, everything about it, no qualms, then you're good. So you don't even need to watch this video, Sammy. Keep moving! Keep moving! Here hangeth my Superior Gear hammock. It's 10 feet in length, but because I have a ridgeline, and this is adjustable Amsteel whoopee sling, I've tied off the little extra there. You can see it's a whoopee sling right here. I have the sag to my preference, 55 inches wide. I love this hammock. I've used it a ton. I use it so much in the winter, except for this winter so far, because we haven't had much snow and we're just now getting it in all this cold, but I got to go have my vocal cord surgery this Friday, so no speak for 3 weeks, they say now. Not even an out loud laugh. And I realized that I talk to the radio and answer back. I'm in trouble. I'm in big trouble. One of the reasons I'm even doing this video is I was reading on hammock forums, and I kind of look in there to see what comes up, what people are talking about. And often the subject of hammock width comes up a lot. Like, a lot of people believe you need a really wide hammock to be comfortable. Now, one thing about this hammock, when I am laying back, and I lay with my head to the right and my feet to the left. Right here is kind of a common thing in hammocks, and there's a little wall of material here. Now, the thing about the Superior Gear hammock, because it's a pretty narrow hammock, it's easy to put my arm right there and just take that wall down, because I don't have a built-in bug net. At least I don't have it hooked up on this particular one. I have another one with the zip-in bug net I can take off, but the wall is not that mighty. I have a great view looking down that way. When I lay in this hammock, or lie, but I wouldn't want to lie to you, I have a really good view out that way, and I can put my arm right here and open that thing up. I really have no calf ridge at all. And calf ridge, as you can see, this little tightness of fabric right here that most hammocks have. If I put my feet this way, you can see there's always a ridge right in the middle. But for some reason, with this hammock, I don't feel it at all. I've really never felt it on any of these 10-foot Superior Gear hammocks. So that sound you hear in the background, that's my furnace running out here in my nut hut, because it's like -3 outside today. We've had some really cold temperatures. Here was my story on length. I got into hammocks in 2006, started doing videos in 2007. In that journey, and a lot of things happened. The first hammock I built was a 10-foot hammock. I was comfortable in it, from what I remember. I knew nothing about calf ridge. I was really ignorant to camping style hammocks, what we call gathered in, because they're gathered at the end. There's no spreader bar. And that was the hammock I was messing with, and still do. And then along the line, I bought a Warbonnet Blackbird, which was a 10-foot hammock. But here's what happened in that journey. Is I was on hammock forums, you know, and going there, and you know, everybody's talking about hammocks and lengths and stuff, and everybody was talking about I'm 6 feet, or I'm 5'11", or I'm 6'4", and I'm way more comfortable in an 11-foot hammock. So I thought, I better try an 11-foot hammock. And I did. And I found it very comfortable. Found my 10-foot very comfortable. The width, you know, I wasn't too concerned with that in the very beginning. I did do this. When I first got into hammocks, I bought an Eno hammock up at REI just to try this stuff out. And it's what they call their double wide or something like that. And what I didn't like about it, and what you'll find with hammocks, is sometimes you think wider is better because we sleep at an angle, but there was a lot of floppy fabric on that one. When I would lay back, it bothered me a lot. I could hardly relax in the hammock with that fabric flopping around. So then I started looking at, or at least being aware of, hammock widths. You know, is more narrow better? Is wider better? Is it length equals width? And let me tell you, hammocks have a lot of range. It depends on the fabrics you're using. Is it single layer? Is it double layer? Who's the manufacturer? How do they sew it? What's your suspension at the end? Is it continual loops? Is it a carabiner? I mean, there's no science to it. It boils down to this, really. And I have to tell people this once in a while that get into hammocks. I say, you know, you might buy this first hammock that you really want to love it, and it's, you want everything to work. And there'll be a couple of pieces of it that just won't work for you. So you have to kind of weigh out, 97% of it is perfect for me. There's that little 3% that bothers me, but there is no perfection in the hammock world, except for sleeping, because I get 10 or 11 hours sleep in the woods. So there's a couple of remedies for the floppy fabric. One is called the Knotty Mod. I think it's better to show you than try to explain it. All right, here I have my Dutchware gear. This is the partial bug net one. I think it's called the half zip or something like that. I'll have to look it up. But this is one of his first ones. And this one, if I stretch the fabric out, we're looking at about the same, 54 inches wide. Actually, this hammock is an 11-foot hammock. It does come with a ridgeline on it, but it has the Knotty Mods. We'll take a look at that. Very comfortable hammock. I'm getting no calf ridge in this one, none at all. Yeah, but at my foot end, there is a little bit of fabric flop, which is why the Knotty Mod is there. And why is it called a Knotty Mod? Well, there's a guy on hammock forums, and he still pops in once in a while, who's, you know, his moniker, you know, your online moniker, your name, is Knotty, K-N-O-T-T-Y, and he came up with this to battle floppy fabric walls on some hammocks. So it has become known as the Knotty Mod, and it's very effective. You can see there's a little bit of loose fabric. In one sense, that's really good because it creates a foot box. Holds the end of your top quilt or sleeping bag in. But here is what the Knotty Mod is. You can see we've got some shock cord going through there. Here's a cinch. And what it does is it comes through the fabric right here at the top of the hammock, this channel. And that's a hem right there. And you can see there's a little hole going in. And it looks to be, I don't know, that's like, I'll measure it in a second. And then it comes out right here. And what you can do is tighten up both of these ends, and it pulls this fabric tight. Same on this side. There's one on both sides. From hole to hole is about, that's about 20 and a half inches right there. All I gotta do here is tighten this up, tighten this one up, and that tightens up that whole piece of fabric right there. And I'm gonna tighten them on this side too, just because they're there, and that was the way I had it. And that will tighten up this whole thing. Did I say tighten up enough? Tighten up, y'all! So now I'm laying in here, and I'm going to show you in a second, but first I'm going to enjoy it. And the edges of my hammock are a little bit more standy-uppy, as I like to call it. And now down there at the end, I have a really nice foot box, and the fabric comes over, but it doesn't flop. It just tightens up that fabric being pulled tight. The thing about the width of a hammock, it does relate to the comfort and how it fits you and what you're willing to put up with or not. I've been surprised, like with the Superior Gear hammocks, how narrow they are, yet how comfortable they are. A lot of hammocks, including the Eno sometimes, sorry Eno, I mean, but you got to make sure they might say a 10-foot hammocker will give inches, but they're giving the raw material size most of the time. Once you factor in the hems, hemming that fabric and stuff, they'll often be a little shorter than you want them to be. So a short hammock, and I've had a lot of people reach out to me where they've even gotten an Eno and said, I'm just not comfortable in it. I'm fine in the backyard here or there, lounging about, but I really tried using it hammock camping and wasn't comfortable for long. Now, some people love the Enos, and I have nothing against Eno. I'm just using them as an example. It's often a fairly short hammock. And a lot of companies, you know, they figure if they, the shorter the hammock, the less fabric they have to use. It all comes down to cost. And again, I'm not saying Eno does that. That's just in general. If you get a hammock and you really feel uncomfortable, it may be that it's too short. So you might want to measure, lay it on the floor flat, measure it, try a 10-foot, try an 11. I'm going to hook up the 12-foot hammock here that someone gave me. Let's see if it's got any floppy fabric, shall we? I forgot, this must be a Dutchware hammock because it does have knotty mods in it. It's got one right there. There's your knotty mods, and there's one on both sides, which is usually what people do. And it's got a knotty mod on this side. Right there, and here. Again, assuming this is the Dutchware, not sure, but I want to thank my friend Jason for sending this to me years ago. Considerably wider than the other two I showed you. This one is 68 inches. I believe it's obvious that I'm laying here, or is it lying here? Though I'd never lie to you. And you can see that I have some hammock flop. All right, we got some flop down here. See all this flop, all this fabric just hanging here. Now, it makes it really wide, and I don't have any calf ridge. You know, the only ones I get a little bit of calf ridge on are my war bonnet hammocks. And war bonnets, more than any other hammock, I love them. Going back to that percentage thing, I love 97% of everything about the war bonnet hammocks, but there's always like a 3 to 7% or somewhere in there. And you have to read that, you know, and on their website, you got to go up into the little bar at the top and it says learning and read exactly how to set theirs up. More than any other hammock, theirs has to be set up, which I think right. But I just love their hammocks. I love everything about it, but they're the most particular in setup. Enough said. I said that, wanted to get that out. So I got a little flop here, got a little flop right there. I got some flop down there. Let me tighten up the knotty mods. I got the knotty mods hooked up, and the flop is pretty gone. And I am going to look up and see if there is a tutorial on knotty mods. And if there is, I'm going to link that down below too. Meaning that way, it's not like I'm linking it off that way or this way, down there. With the knotty mods tightened up, takes care of a lot of that flop.
Why is the hammock your muse?
Because I get 12 or 11 hours sleep in the woods. And it also fascinates me that something so simple in concept can be so complex. But, you know, don't be afraid. If you've got a hammock and you just, you have to admit to yourself that you go, I like it, I like sleeping in it, I like what it does. I wasn't comfortable throughout the night. Sometimes that's just going to take you a little while to get used to. But do not discount that your hammock may not fit you. It may not be the right length, it may not be the right width, it may not be the right fabric. I have a video on different fabrics and double and single layer hammocks. I'm going to put those down below. I'll point, like, you can't figure that out. The fabric one's boring, but when I did it, I learned a lot about fabrics and the stretch and the feel and the slickness or the roughness of how they support the body. Do they give? Do they not give? All those come into play. Again, it's like buying a pair of pants. You know, if they've got a little spandex in them, they give a little bit. You buy some pants, you love everything about them. You try them on, you want to love them. You just don't like the feel of the fabric up against your legs and whatnot. And then people often ask, well, your underquilt, if you have a really wide hammock, you have to get a really wide underquilt. No, you don't. Your underquilt doesn't have to come up and cover fabric that's not being used. It just has to cover your body and right up to your shoulder. So you can put any underquilt on a really wide hammock. You know, something to think about if you're into hammocks or if you're thinking about getting into hammocks, that they have to fit you. They have to fit you right. And you're not going to know it for a while. It's like I've been playing the electric bass for 13 months now, and I've gone through several iterations. Yes, I use the word iteration of basses. Trying different ones. I'm still in the search for the ones that the one or two that I really like the best. It's like, as far as hammocks go, I've covered just about everything except maybe this topic, and I have discovered the hammocks that I like and that I use the most. And these days, it's probably wintertime, I use those Superior Gear hammocks with the built-in underquilts. It just say they work. I've never been cold. They've proven the point. During the rest of the year, I often take a war bonnet. I like the design of their bug knot. I like the design of their bug net. Or bug knot, as some people, I said naughty mod too much. It's a bug knot. I love the design of their bug net. It's up off my face. I can lean back and relax. I can add my own underquilt. I really like their hammocks for the summer. So it's really been, for the last couple of years, the hammocks I've used the most would be War Bonnet and Superior Gear. So eventually you'll come down to your groove. So it has to fit you. You have to wear your hammock well. And let me know in the comments if the first hammock you got is still the first hammock you use. And I don't mean you've had it for 3 months. Like, you've been using it, let's say 5 years. What hammocks within your 5-year range have you stuck with or down to now? What did you start with? Other people are looking for ultra light, like the hummingbirds. I haven't tried a hummingbird hammock. I heard they're short and narrow, but some people seem to love them. So it's like all backpacking. Weight comes into it, how you carry, what kind of pack you have, what you use as a sleeping system, what you use as a shelter, what you use to cook. So many variables. I love that about backpacking. It's got a lot of range. You could go on and on about it. It's not worth arguing about, but it's fun to talk about because everybody's different, which is the point of why I'm doing this video. I've seen it come up a lot lately about hammock width mainly, and it gets me to thinking all the time about your hammock has to fit you well. And when you get in it, you got to feel really good. You want to feel the best because you are going to sleep for the night. It's the end of your day and you don't want to wake up and 4 hours. No, you want 8 to 12 hours of sleep. In a hammock, 99.9% of the time, I am sleeping 10 to 12 hours. And a lot of you that have watched my videos of trip reports know that that's the case. I say it all the time. I feel well rested when I hike the next day. The hammocks have a restorative quality to me. Like, I'm sore. I'm 65 now. And when I walk, I'm sore, gimpy. You know, I still try to go hard, but I go as hard as I can for my age. And at the end of the day, I'm sore. But when I wake up in the morning, I feel good. I'm restored. Thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. Gonna have the surgery. I don't know if I'll be putting out a video while I can't talk. Who knows? It'll be a lot of... Anyway, woo, buddy! All secure in Sector 7. Shug saying goodbye, ta-ta, auf Wiedersehen for now. Thank you.